FinTech Convergence Council and Payment Council of India, of Internet and Mobile Association of India and National Payment Corporation of India. The fest is presented by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India, Reserve Bank of India, and supported by Niti Aayog, Startup India, and Invest India. We would like to thank our partners, Platinum Partner Visa, AWS and PhonePe, Diamond Partner Cred, Country Partner Australian Government, Track Partner HSBC India and Refinitiv India, and Session Partner the UK Government of the UK Government Department of International Trade. Our next session is a product launch on the launch of SHG transaction through AEPS. Our speaker for this session is Mr. Denny Thomas, Head NETC and AEPS NPCI. Over to you, Mr. Danny.
Thank you, Ritika, for having me for this session. I'm really excited to launch the self-help group dual authentication services on the AEPS platform. AEPS, which is basically the Aadhaar-enabled payment system, which was launched by NPCI way back in 2011 with a single objective of providing the basic banking services to the underserved customer segment, right? With AEPS, we reached out to those remotest of the remotest villages, areas of Bharat, where a customer had to actually travel miles to kind of avail a basic banking service or to kind of get into a bank branch. With AEPS, a banking correspondent literally kind of brought the bank to the customer's village, and we provide doorstep banking with various services like cash withdrawal, balance inquiry, fund transfer, or for that matter, a mini statement, which is kind of given through a micro ATM, right? There are 140 banks today providing the AEPS services across the country, with over 2 million terminals deployed, spread across Kashmir to Kanyakumari, 340 million customers availed AEPS services last financial year. So not many people know the power of AEPS services because of the reach that we have. In fact, the entire world has been very excited with biometric payments, and the phenomenon has been very recent, right? NPCI, along with UIDAI, we have been providing this biometric authentication services for payments since 2011. And it has become one of the, most popular payment products within the rural segment, primarily because of the ease of use to the customer, right? As a customer, I don't have to carry any of my bank details. I just have to walk into a BC point, provide my Aadhaar number or my virtual ID number, right? And just mention my bank name to which the Aadhaar is linked, to the account to which the Aadhaar is linked. The bank name is just to be mentioned, and just kind of give my biometric on the scanner, which acts as a second factor of authentication. And that's the just one authentication. Self-help groups require dual authentication, primarily because you have multiple signatories when you open up a self-help group bank account. So that was the challenge, and we kind of created that solution, and we provided the dual authentication process, and which kind of will enable us to now target almost 7 million self-help groups. And each of these groups will be having at least 10 to 12 members. So while we would be kind of facilitating the transactions for the self-help group, the platform would also provide a way where any of these self-help groups can also kind of act as a banking correspondent. And in fact, we are expecting a lot of these female self-help group members to become banking correspondents, which would add as an additional income source by providing these services in their groups as well as in villages. So without further ado, Ritika, let's have the launch video.
IPS or Aadhaar enabled payment system launched in 2011 has been one of the cornerstones of the financial inclusion in India. With assisted service delivery, doorstep banking and Aadhaar biometric based authentication, AEPS has been able to solve for accessibility, availability, affordability and authentication while catering to the underserved. The product has been a major enabler for the masses. It allows for cash withdrawal, cash deposit, mini statement, balance inquiry, Bheem Aadhaar Pay and fund transfer. In quarter 1 of financial year 2021, when the country was in lockdown, it enabled over 22 crore Indians to access their bank accounts and the direct benefit transfer. With over 20 lakh active terminals across country, the product had served a total of over 34 crore Indians in the financial year 2021. In its mission to touch every Indian with one or other payment methods, NPCI is enabling self-help group transactions through dual authentication in AEPS. Self-help groups or SHGs are small uniform group of individuals, often women, under the aegis of DNRLM, Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India, NABARD and RBI. These groups often have a jointly held bank account under the Bank Linkage Program. The group enables the members to cultivate the habit of savings through formal banking and access microloans. Here's a small use case on how the SHG transactions can be beneficial for the customers. Meena Kumari, Sampath Devi and Nirmala are part of Grama Jyoti self-help group in small village. The SHG has 12 other members. Meena Kumari and Sampath Devi work as farm laborers like other members in the group, while Nirmala is an Asha worker in the Anganwadi. The group meets in weekly meeting and engages in small savings and loans to their needy members. They have also maintained an account in the ABC Bank branch in their tehsil, for which Meena Kumari, Sampath Devi and Nirmala are the signatories. But here is the problem. The bank is 20 km away from their village, and for transactions on the account, it would require at least two of them to sign. For making withdrawals to lend to the members or making deposits of the money collected in the meetings, they have to travel to the bank branch, often leading to a loss of a day's wage. They would often postpone this travel till enough money collected in their steel box, leading to a loss of interest they could have otherwise earned from the bank. With AEPS SHG transactions, Meena Kumari, Sampath Devi and Nirmala Kumari can simply visit the PC point in their village, make deposits or withdrawals only using their Aadhaar and biometrics to authorize the transaction. They can also use this mode to directly transfer the loan amount to SHG members' bank account. No more hassle of cash management, wage loss or interest loss. We also hear that Nirmala Kumari is enrolling as BC Sakhi of DNRLM, Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India, and start at BC Point herself to further support her group and the village.
Namaste, a very warm welcome to all the delegates of the FinTech Festival. I am R. Shering, Chief General Manager, NABARD, in charge of Department of Financial Inclusion and Banking Technology. I am extremely happy that NPCI is launching the second edition of Global FinTech Festival. It is a great day for all of us, as now SHGs will be able to perform basic banking activities from any BC points through AEPS, enabling offers functionality apart from honors functionality on micro ATMs is a great step to digitize the payment ecosystem of SHGs. NABARD has been playing a pivotal role for the bank linkage of SHG since 1990s through various initiatives such as the SHG Bank Linkage Program. NABARD has been providing financial support to the RRBs and the rural cooperative banks to avail AUA and KUA membership from UIDAI in order to provide Aadhaar-enabled payment system. In addition to this, financial support is provided by NABARD for enabling dual authentication feature on micro ATMs of SEBs and RRBs. I am sure the AEPS will help in financial inclusion of women and promote more number of SHG women members.
The Ministry of Rural Development is implementing the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Rural Livelihood Mission, under which we are trying to bring one woman from each rural poor family in the SHG network. Already we have been able to cover more than 7.7 crore rural women and brought them into more than 71 lakh self-help groups. One of the important agenda under the National Rural Livelihood Mission is the financial inclusion of these women. We are also trying to move them more and more towards digital transactions. However, due to lack of banking points in the rural areas, these women find it very difficult to access the banking services. In order to address this, we have been trying to develop PC agents from amongst the women self-help group members. These banking correspondent agents, or the BC Kakis as we call them, have been trained by the rural self-employment training institutions and also certified by the IIBF. They have been doing extremely good work in bringing a lot of banking services to the rural poor people at their doorsteps, like payment of NREGA wages, social security, pensions, scholarships, etc. In fact, they have also undergone a lot of hardships during the COVID period to make these services available to the rural population. Over the last few years, they have been able to do more than 4.97 crore transactions, amounting to more than 17,275 crore rupees. However, the BC network has not been able to cater to the transactions for the self-help groups because the technology existing at the point did not allow for dual authentication. With the cooperation of the Department of Financial Services and the Reserve Bank of India, and with the technological support from NPCI, the office solution was implemented by the banks to address this issue. This has actually opened a lot of possibility for bringing the SHG transactions under the banking network. Subsequently, NPCI has also put in place the offer solution. What is required now is to have a standardized protocol for implementing this across the banks. This has really been a very important technological upgrade because it allows all the large number of transactions that is happening in the ecosystem of the SHGs, which amounts to thousands of crores, to be brought in under the banking network. This will be very useful for the banks, but it will also be very, very useful for the SHG members, because not only will it make make the transactions very simple for them. So far, all the transactions that have been happening in cash form will become digital. But more importantly, it will also help them in creating a credit history, both for the SHG as well as their members, which will in future help them in accessing more and more credit from the banks. I'm really grateful to the cooperation from Department of Financial Services and the Reserve Bank of India, and especially for the technological solutions provided by NPCI, because this is going to be of immense use to the rural women under the National Rural Livelihood Mission. Thank you.
To hear that NPCI is launching SHG dual authentication application on its APS platform. This interoperable solution will allow about 70 million women connected to their self-help groups to transact seamlessly using their bank accounts without the need to go to bank branches. This is phenomenal news. Not only this bridges the digital divide between Bharat and India, this also helps in plugging the gap, the gender gap, in the same ecosystem. We now hopefully soon will get to see more and more women applying their use case to the digital platform through the AEPS pipe. I'm sure this is going to be a win-win situation for all stakeholders, be it banks, be it the community who's going to use this, or the agent channel, the network that will facilitate this. Banks not only get a better visibility of nearly $20 billion loan portfolio that they have with the SAG ecosystem, because more and more transactions happen through the bank account and not in cash outside the banking system. The women who use will get to transact through their bank account, and the bank accounts will have more transactions, more balance, will help them save more because it is in the neighborhoods, same community, women who is well known to them, who will facilitate these transactions. And of course, the agent channel will get to pipe more and more transactions and services thereby, adding to their revenue. I clearly look forward to the rollout of this solution, and we are happy to be partnering with NRLM. I'm sure with NRLM's help, NPCI and commercial banks will be able to roll this out quickly on ground. And this is perhaps just the first use case which is going to be put to test. There are many such use cases which involve operations in joint accounts. It could be association of persons, some collectives, for example, federations, producer groups. I'm sure similar use cases will come up and can be activated of varied kinds. For example, a producer group needs to pay to their parent FPO or to their members. Now, this will allow these producer groups to also transact through the same VC channel and bring in more and more efficiency into the system. I clearly look forward to continued association and scale up, and congratulations to NPCI and NRLM for taking this forward. Thank you.
Good morning. The COVID-19 pandemic has left behind a lot of lessons, and chief among them being how technology and digitization has helped us resolve a lot of issues and also helped us to reach out to the rural poor. Self-help groups have always brought communities together and have boosted the rural economy. SBI has always endeavored to serve the underserved and has collaborated with NPCI or partnered with NPCI on a lot of digital initiatives to reach out to the rural poor or to serve the underserved. One of the initiatives that NPCI has taken and which SBI has partnered with them is the new functionality that has been developed over the ATS for SHGs to do transactions. I think this will go a long way in promoting digitization and helping the rural poor to do transactions at doorsteps. To place on record our appreciation of NPCI for having taken these initiatives, I think this will go a very long way in our efforts to serve the underserved.
AEPS powered by NPCI.
Thanks, Ritika, for playing that video. I just wanted to re-emphasize the importance of this particular launch, because the COVID situation actually kind of got us believe that the AEPS infrastructure is one of the most important infrastructure for the country today. Because when during the peak COVID times, when people were struggling to even kind of get to ATM or a branch, the BC network kind of stood as a rock pillar, which kind of supported the entire country in terms of giving the cash when it was needed the most. So extending this to SHG groups, self-help groups, kind of is just a starting point, because with dual authentications, we would also open up a lot of other producer organizations, farm producer organizations, FPOs and all, which have a similar requirement. This is just the beginning with the SAG, where we'll have much more user groups getting added onto this dual authentication process. I want to thank MORD and DFS particularly for kind of helping us out in creating this solution. I always keep on saying technology is one of the most easiest things to crack. It is the other issues, operational issues, which kind of needs to get sorted out. And that can only happen through the policy directions. And thanks MORD and DFS for that, and RBI especially. I also want to kind of thank NABARD, because they have been supporting our programs and kind of helping us in all the possible manner. And last but not least, I would also take this opportunity to thank all our member banks who have been associated with AEPS, because they are the real pillars, right? They provide the railroads to the end customers. So I'm expecting that all the 140 member banks would be kind of ready on the SAG platform soon. Thanks, Ritika. Thanks. Over to you.
Thank you, Denny. We really enjoyed this session. A lot of good, insightful session. So thank you so much. And thank you to all the delegates for being a part of this session. Thank you. Thank you, Denny.